what I can bring, they can't get anymore.
Well, this is what I was wondering. Like, you know, you spoke about in the interview that the thing that you learned from George was not around creative and cooking, but it was about being a restaurateur.
Yeah.
And I guess, do you feel like that was one of the things you really learned? Is it's finding the right people and putting them in the right places? Is that what changed for you?
Yeah, definitely. And I mean, I know that George is getting a lot of backlash at the moment and his world's turning to shit, and I feel really bad for him, you know, because it's he doesn't deserve it.
No. A lot of former staff feel that way too.
Yeah, I mean, it's ridiculous.
Yeah.
But he was always very good at... He was good with people and identifying who's great in what role and really empowering them to do what they had to do. I haven't always been so great at that. I think it comes with maturity as well. And it comes with self-esteem. You know, I think when your self-esteem is good and you're happy within yourself, you don't feel like you have to, I'm talking for myself, you don't have to control everything. Like when my self-esteem is not great and I'm not so happy, I'm very reluctant to let other people help me because I feel like, oh, I have to do this. I have to make myself better. I have to fix this kind of thing. When you feel good about yourself and things are great and you're relaxed and you've got good people around you, you're kind of happy to push things back and just kind of let things happen, I think. Mm.
Yeah, you become more of a maestro.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think George was always kind of good at that in those early years.
Yeah.
And he was good at that even before then. I think even we were at the same year level as apprentices. And even at that level, he was very good at asserting himself.
Uh-huh.
So,
what do you wish you could tell him today?
I mean, we didn't speak for a few years. You know, people get in each other's ears, you know, and I think you always have to go back to what you had in the core. And in the core, we were really good friends.
Mm.
You know, we're still friends now. We don't speak as often as we could. And I just think that I just wish, and I think I don't know, I haven't spoke to him. I just hope that in his next, when he rises again, and he will rise again, that he has better people around him. You know, that he has people around him that actually are willing to invest what he's invested. And I just don't just mean about money.
Mm.
And that are in it for the right reasons.
Effort.
Yeah, effort, yeah. Love, determination, willing to sacrifice. And you know, he's always had a goal of just being a great cook and creating great experiences. I think somewhere along that line, and I've been guilty of it too, we start to fall victim to the seven deadly sins, you know? Mm. And then they start to just, it starts to blur the lines. And you start to lose focus on what you actually makes you happy.
Yeah.
And it's not the money and it's not the endorsements and it's not the popularity and all the other shit. That's all great. But that's where Maha keeps me good. Because
yeah.
We get, like, all that stuff sometimes, it's just you're drawn to the light. But she's kind of pulls you back and goes, yeah, okay, we can, that's nice and we can have that, but fucking sit down.
But you know? This goes back to what you mentioned before about that staff member and how important it is to have the right people. You know, being an executive in a restaurateur is probably one of the hardest executive positions in the business world, I think. The highest pressure position because, you know, let's just look at Australia. All the costs across the board have gone up far more than most other industries.
Yeah.
It's quite, when people actually look at the hospitality industry, it's incredibly hard these days.
Especially when you consider that most of the people in, like myself and George, We're cooks, you know, like we're chefs.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, we haven't been through, done a Harvard business degree.
Yeah, you've not done MBAs and all that.
We're cooks.
Yeah.
And that's not like we should be saying, you know, poor me and cut us some slack. But we evolve into these roles and some of us are more naturally, I suppose, gifted or have these strengths where they can move into management and understand business and some don't and they just are always that chef that's out of his depth. Mm. I feel that I've always been a better businessman than a chef. And what's made me a better businessman is admitting that I'm not a great businessman.
Yeah.
Admitting
that you know nothing is one of the best traits to have.
Yeah, but then also being fortunate enough to have some amazing friends. I've got amazing friends. And yeah. I don't call them my network. They're my friends. And they really care for me. And they are all what I don't have. They are the educated people. They are the people running multi-billion dollar funds and, you know, international events are very well respected and have a lot more life experience than me. And I'm never too shy to ask for help, even just for a coffee and just to talk to them. I feel like I leave there, not just with a great conversation as a mate, but I feel enriched, you know, like I felt like I've learned something, whether it's something personal or professional, whatever, you know, brilliant friends. And none of them push me to, you know, grow my ego. You know, I feel like I'm lucky to be around them. It's not the other way around. They're not fueling me. So it's nice.